Feel free, and Glanford breaking over to Julian Wilson.
And Zimulator's down on that one, and that leaves, and also down is Roughhouse. Roughhouse is on the floor. And another faller at that one, I can't see. But as they come to the next, it's Feel Free from Glanford Brick towards the inside. And these two are clear. That's the fifth fence, and they're over it. Feel Free from Glanford Brick, then Lescargo. On the outside of Lescargo is the Dickler going very strong. Red Rum's about in the center of the field. Right at the back is Roughhouse, and Castle Ruddery refused there as they run down to Beaches. The two leaders at Beaches are Feel Free and Glanford Brick. Those two clear over it, and they both cleared it from the Dickler. After the Dicker, and Spit and Image is a faller at that one, and April 7th has also gone at Beecher's, and as they run down to the next, the two leaders are Glanford Brick, who jumps it clear from Feel Free. In third place is the Dickler. In fourth place is Beau Bob. Lescargo made a mistake in fifth place. In sixth is Glen Owen. In seventh is Southern Quest. Then comes High Ken and Money Market. After that comes Tudor View. And Royal Relief is a faller at that last one. Spanish Steps is still with the field as they come to the canal turn. And over it, it was Glanford Brick from Field 3. Beau Bob jumps it in third. The Dickler is fourth. High Ken is fifth. Southern Quest is sixth. Lescargo is seventh. Eighth is Money Market. Then comes Tudor View and Glen Owen. And Bally Richard again was a faller at that one as Glanford Brick jumps Valentine's in the lead, and all the leaders are over Valentine's. The field headed by Glanford Brick from Feel Free, then Beau Bob and the Dickler, then High Ken and Southern Quest, then Lescargo and Money Market and Tudor View as we rejoin John Hanmer.
And Glanford Brick in the lead from Feel Free, then comes Beau Bob and Southern Quest, then the Dickler. Behind the Dickler is High Ken, then Lescargo, Tudor View, Money Market, Manicou Bay as they come to the next. And Glanford Brick over first, Feel Free second, then Beau Bob, Southern Quest, the Dickler, High Ken, then Lescargo and Tudor View, Manicou Bay, Money Market. Behind Money Market is Spanish Steps and Red Rum just in behind those and going easily at the moment. And Glanford Brick the leader from Feel Free, Beau Bob, Southern Quest, the Dickler, High Ken, Lescargo, Tudor View, Manicou Bay, Money Market, then Kilmore Boy, Red Rum. Behind Red Rum, Spanish Steps, then Halley Percy and Glen Owen, then Landlark, Rag Trade. Behind Rag Trade is Even Dawn, but as they go back onto the race course, it's Glanford Brick in the lead from Feel Free, Southern Quest, and Beau Bob, and over to Peter O'Sullivan.
Yes, Glanford Brick blazing the trail and at a cracking pace too, with Beau Bob right up there and Southern Quest towards the outside, and Feel Free comes next. Then a little gap to High Ken, who's going well, with the Dickler just in behind him, and then Lescargo, then Manicou Bay. Behind Manicou Bay is Tudor View. Behind Tudor View is Money Market on the inside of Kilmore Boy, and then comes Red Rum, and just in behind Red Rum is Halley Percy with Glen Owen and Spanish Steps, and then Rag Trade, and then Landlark coming to the next now. And Glanford Brick drunks it in the lead from Southern Quest, and Feel Free's a faller there. Feel Free has gone at that one, and as they come up towards the next, he's brought down Tudor View. It's Glanford Brick. Glanford Brick still in the lead from Southern Quest. Then comes Beau Bob on the inside, then Lescargo. Just in behind Lescargo is Manicou Bay, and then High Ken, and then the Dickler, and then Money Market and Spanish Steps, and behind them Red Rum and Kilmore Boy, and then Rag Trade. Then comes Landlark, and then Halley Percy as they come to the chair, led by a pack of loose horses who could cause a pack of trouble here. And it's Glanford Brick who jumps it in the lead from Beau Bob on the outside, then Southern Quest, and then Lescargo and Manicou Bay, and then the Dickler. Landlark was brought down there. And as they come to the water, it's Glanford Brick in the lead from Beau Bob. Just in behind Beau Bob is Southern Quest, and then the Dickler and Manicou Bay, and then High Ken, and then Lescargo. Behind Lescargo is Spanish Steps, and then comes Red Rum, then Kilmore Boy and Rag Trade. Behind Rag Trade is Money Market and Glen Owen. Behind Glen Owen is Halley Percy. Then comes Ballyath and Rough Silk. They're the only ones left standing, and as they go out into the country on the second circuit, it's Glanford Brick in the lead from Beau Bob, Southern Quest, High Ken, Lescargo, the Dickler. Then comes Spanish Steps and Manicou Bay and Money Market and Red Rum and Kilmore Boy and Rag Trade and Glen Owen, and then Halley Percy, and it's back to John Hanmer.
And Glanford Brick the leader, then Southern Quest and Beau Bob and Lescargo, then Red Rum taking close order, then comes High Ken as they jump the 17th. Glanford Brick jumped it well in the lead, all the leaders over safely. Southern Quest is second, Lescargo third, then High Ken, then comes Beau Bob and Red Rum, then Kilmore Boy and Rag Trade, the Dickler going easily on the inside just behind the leaders as they jump the 18th. And again, all the leaders over it safely, with Lanford Brig disputing it with High Ken and Southern Quest, then the Dickler, then Lascargo and Red Rum, behind Red Rum, Manicou Bay, then Beau Bob as they jump the ditch. And High Ken jumped to the front, a magnificent leap by High Ken, and he's out in front now of Southern Quest, then Lanford Brig, Lascargo, the Dickler, Red Rum, then Manicou Bay, Kilmore Boy, Money Market under pressure, then comes Spanish Steps as they jump the next and over to Julian Wilson.
And High Ken clears it in front. What a ride Barry Brogan's having. Lanford Brig's on his inside towards the outside as Red Rum cruising up towards the leaders. Just on his inside is Southern Quest. Just behind these is Lascargo. The Dickler's there on the inside. Then comes Manicou Bay and Kilmore Boy as they jump the one before Beaches, and High Ken has gone. High Ken's a faller at that one, and the ones behind him have just escaped the trouble. And that leaves Lanford Brig in front again from Red Rum, cruising up on the outside of Southern Quest. And these are the three leaders as they come to Beaches for the second time. Lanford Brig from Southern Quest and Red Rum. Then comes the Dickler and Lascargo at Beaches, and Southern Quest over from Red Rum and Lanford Brig. Then comes the Dickler. The leaders are all over. Lascargo's next from Money Market and Manicou Bay, then Kilmore Boy. Just behind Kilmore Boy is Spanish Step, and Beau Bob is a follower at that one. And at the 23rd, and it's Red Rum who makes a slight mistake there, and Southern Quest is back in front from Lanford Brig and Red Rum. Then comes the Dickler in fourth, Lascargo is fifth, Manicou Bay is sixth, then Money Market in the outside of Kilmore Boy. Then comes Spanish Steps as the leaders race towards the canal turn for the last time. And it's Southern Quest on the outside of Lanford Brig. Red Rum is over in third, the Dickler is fourth, Lascargo is fifth, then Manicou Bay sixth, then Spanish Steps and Money Market, Kilmore Boy, and they're a long way in front of Glen Owen. Then comes Halley Percy and Rag Trade as the leaders jump Valentine's. And over it, it was Southern Quest from Red Rum. Red Rum takes the lead from Southern Quest. Kilmore Boy was a faller at that last one. Lanford Brig still there in the inside, as is Lascargo. These four almost in line. Then comes the Dickler in fifth. Spanish Steps moves into sixth. Then after that is Money Market and Manicou Bay as we rejoin John Hammer.
And Red Rum in the lead from Southern Quest, Lascargo, then Lanford Brig and the Dickler. These all closely grouped, and they're clear of Spanish Steps and Money Market. Then comes Manicou Bay. And over the next, Red Rum just the leader from Southern Quest. Then comes Lascargo, the Dickler, Lanford Brig losing ground quickly. Then Spanish Steps and Money Market and Manicou Bay. And they've got just three to jump. And it's Lascargo and Red Rum, the first and second last year. And Red Rum jumps it in front from Lascargo, then Southern Quest. Then comes the Dickler, behind the Dickler, Spanish Steps. Then Money Market still being chased along. Then Lanford Brig and Manicou Bay. And these are a long way clear of Halley Percy and Rag Trade. And these seem to be the only ones in it. But as they go across the milling road, it's Red Rum and Lascargo matching strides, clear of the Dickler and over to Peter O'Sullivan.
Yes, it's last year's first and second, Red Rum and Lascargo. Red Rum with 12 stone and Lascargo with 11-3 this time. Tommy Carberry on the inside of Brian Fletcher as they come up towards the second last in the National, with the Dickler third, Spanish Steps four, Money Market five, six Southern Quest and seven Lanford Brig and eight Manicou Bay. And these eight, virtually the only ones left in it now as they come to the second last. Lascargo and Red Rum together as they come to the second last. And they touch down together. Red Rum and Lascargo. On the right of the picture, it's Lascargo, Tommy Carberry. On the left, it's Red Rum trying to make national history with Brian Fletcher, and he's the first under pressure, Red Rum, as they come to the final fence in the National. In third place is Spanish Steps, and over the last, they touch down together. Spanish Steps and Red Rum. And Red Rum now with a fractional advantage. Red Rum with Lascargo, rather, with a fractional advantage now over Red Rum. And Lascargo is going to avenge last year's defeat. And Tommy Carberry is going to become the first jockey in history to win the Gold Cup and the Irish National and the English National. It's Lascargo strides clear, 12 years old, to win the National for Raymond Guest. And here he comes to the line, Lascargo, the comfortable winner of the 1975 National, the little hero who won it last year and the year before. Red Rum is second, Spanish Steps come to the line third.
Lascargo was only the second horse in steeplechasing history to win both the Grand National and the Gold Cup, emulating the great Golden Miller's achievement in the 1930s. Sam Snail.
Complete the course in the 1975 National.
In 1976, Red Rum, such a gallant runner-up to Lascargo, again ran second, this time to Rag Trade, and this time ridden by Tommy Stack. So Rummy went into the 1977 National boasting the remarkable record of two wins and two seconds from four runs. And he became the flagship horse for an event being professionally marketed for the first time. With Tommy Stack again in the saddle and again carrying top weight, 12-year-old Red Rum started at 9-1 with only Andy Pandy on 15-2 preferred in the betting. 42 runners faced the starter for what was to prove the most historic Grand National of the television era.
The starter calling for the course to be cleared.
All right?
The contestants, he asked them if they're all right. And this looks like it, they're off. And Spitten Image on the far side is the first to show of that group, and Boom Docker on the near side with Andy Pandy, and Nerio right up with him, and San Willen and Brown Admiral. And over on the far side, Spitten Image, with going up with him, Collingwood on the near side, it's Boom Docker. And as they cross the Melling Road, and we go over to join John Hammer, it's Boom Docker from Sebastian, Brown Admiral, San Willen, and Andy Pandy, and what a buck. And over to you, John.
And Sebastian just about the leader at the first on the inside from Duffelcoat on the outside, and Duffelcoat has gone. He's the first one to go. It looked as if Spitting Image went as well. Willie Watt has gone. And as they go to the second fence, it's Sebastian in the lead from Prince Rock, then Brown Admiral, then Forest King, then comes Andy Pandy. No fallers at the second fence, and at the third, the big ditch, it's Sebastian in the lead from Prince Rock, and Brown Admiral and Forest King have made a mistake. The fall there, Davy Laird has gone, and Innie Carrow has gone. Verrata has gone, and also Royal Thrust, and over to Julian Wilson.
And over that one, Sebastian led towards the centre, towards the far side is Prince Rock, towards the stand side is Boom Docker with San Willen, Brown Admiral just behind the leaders, then comes Hidden Value, and tracking the leaders on the far side is Sage Merlins. They jumped the one before Beecher. Sebastian over from over in second, Boom Docker, then came Hidden Value in the centre, Prince Rock towards the far side, and also behind that on the far side is Sage Merlin. Then comes Brown Admiral as they race down towards Beecher's with Sebastian leading from Boom Docker, Prince Rock, Hidden Value, and Brown Admiral over Beecher's. Sebastian over. And Sebastian's gone at Beecher's. Sebastian's a faller. Another faller, Songwriter, is brought down at the back of the field. And Winter Rain is also a faller at Beecher's. And Castle Rudder is a faller at Beecher's. And Lord of the Hill also. And Charlotte Brew is just over. She's over last of all, and she's been badly impeded. But over the next one, and racing down towards the canal turn, is now Boom Docker in the lead from Brown Admiral second, Hidden Value is third, then comes Prince Rock and Forest King on the inside of Sage Merlin, then comes San Willen and Andy Pandy as they jump the canal turn, and over it was Boom Docker from Brown Admiral, Hidden Value, a bad mistake there by Forest King. In fourth place is Prince Rock, fifth is Forest King, sixth is Sage Merlin, then comes San Willen behind that, and Andy Pandy and Roman Barr, and then comes Red Rum as they jump that one, and still out front is Boom Docker. Boom Docker by 10 lengths from Brown Admiral second, Hidden Value third. In fourth on the outside is Prince Rock with Sage Merlin. Then comes Forest King as they jump the next, and we rejoin John Hammer.
And Pengrail was a faller at the first, and so was Warbonnet, but it's Boom Docker out clear of Prince Rock. Then Sage Merlin is in third place. Over this next fence, Boom Docker over in the lead, not so far in front now of Sage Merlin. Then comes Prince Rock, then Brown Admiral and Hidden Value. And then comes Red Ram, who's going well. And as they go to what will be the third last on the next circuit, it's Boom Docker out clear. Sage Merlin is second, Prince Rock third. And Prince Rock went there. And that leaves Hidden Value in third place. Then comes Andy Pandy and Red Ram and Brown Admiral. Then comes Roman Barr and Forest King. And as they head towards the 13th fence, it's Boom Docker out clear of Sage Merlin, Hidden Value, Andy Pandy and Red Ram. And Charlotte Bruce still going as we join Peter O'Sullivan.
And Boom Docker a long way clear. Sage Merlin heading the remainder ahead of Hidden Value. Then comes Andy Pandy, then Red Rum. Just in behind them come Brown Admiral going strongly, and Roman Barr and Forest King. But as they come down now towards the 13th, it's Boom Docker a long way clear of Sage Merlin, who's going to jump it second, jumping it third. Is Hidden Value, Red Rum and Andy Pandy next, followed by Roman Barr and Brown Admiral, then comes Sir Garnet going well. As they come down to the next, Boom Docker well clear of Sage Merlin, and then closely grouped are Red Rum, Happy Ranger, Andy Pandy, Hidden Value, Brown Admiral, What a Buck, Sir Garnet. Behind Sir Garnet is Nerio coming to the chair now, Boom Docker. Boom Docker a long way clear at the chair. And he's over the 15th, clear. Sage Merlin comes in to jump it second, and he's down. Sage Merlin a faller there. Hidden Value jumps it next from What a Buck. Andy Pandy behind them, Brown Admiral. Then comes Red Rum and Roman Barr, and then Sir Garnet and Boom Docker clear over the water. And it's Andy Pandy who leads the next group over the water, followed by Hidden Value and Waterbuck and Brown Admiral, then Roman Barr, and then comes Red Rum, then Sir Garnet on the inside, then Sandwithin and Forest King and Nerio and Happy Ranger, then the Pilgarlic, then comes Churchtown Boy. On the inside of Churchtown Boy is Zeta Sun, and behind them come Eye Catcher, then Collingwood, then Carroll Street, and the Songwriter. A long way back behind the Songwriter is Gay Vulgan, then Foresail. Behind Foresail is Charlotte Brew, just taking the water, getting a cheer from the crowd as going down out into the country. Boom Dockers, a long way clear of Andy Pandy and Waterbuck, and Barony Fort still continuing, and over to John Hanmer.
Docker refuse when well clear at the 17th, and this leaves Andy Pandy in front, all the leaders over that safely. It's Andy Pandy out clear himself now of Hidden Value, then Waterbuck on the inside. Then comes Red Rum, and they're over the 18th. And all the leaders once again jumping it safely, though a mistake by Collingwood, and it's Andy Pandy coming to the ditch in the lead from Waterbuck, Hidden Value, Red Rum, then Roman Barr, Brown Admiral and Nerio, then comes Sir Garnet and Forest King. And going to the 20th fence, it's Andy Pandy clear of Waterbuck, then Nerio, and then comes Roman Barr, Hidden Value, Red Rum and Brown Admiral, and over to Julian Wilson.
Yes, and Andy Pandy is well clear from Waterbuck in second place. Towards the outside is Red Rum, who's going really well as they come down to the one before Beaches, and Andy Pandy is 10 lengths clear over it. Andy Pandy from Waterbuck over in second, Nerio's over in third, then Red Rum towards the outside. Behind those are Happy Ranger, then Brown Admiral, Churchtown Boy rather, behind that. Just behind that is Sir Garnet, towards the inside is Brown Admiral, and Hidden Value as the leader comes to Beecher's Book for the second time, and Andy Pandy is down, Andy Pandy down at Beecher's, Nerio is also down at Beecher's, and Brown Admiral's gone at Beecher's as well, but the rest of the field are over, and coming to the 23rd fence, it's now Red Rum disputing it with Waterbuck. Just behind these is Churchtown Boy, then Happy Ranger and Sir Garnet, and over that one, it's Red Rum who leads. Red Rum is the leader as they race down towards the canal turn. Red Rum from Churchtown Boy and Waterbuck, then Happy Ranger, and behind that is the Pilgarlic and Sir Garnet as Red Rum jumps the canal turn in front. Red Rum by two or three lengths from Churchtown Boy in second, in third is Waterbuck in fourth, and Sir Garnet's a faller there. In fourth is Happy Ranger, in fifth is the Pilgarlic, sixth is Eye Catcher, seventh is Hidden Value, eighth is Forest Rock, ninth is Cedar Sun, tenth is Eye Catcher as they come to the next, and we rejoin John Hanmer.
And it's Red Rum in a clear lead from Churchtown Boy in second place. Red Rum over there, he pecks slightly on landing. Churchtown Boy second, Waterbuck is third, the Pilgarlic is fourth, then comes Happy Ranger. And this is the last ditch, the fourth from home. And Red Rum's in the lead, a lot of loose horses after him. Churchtown Boy's over second, the Pilgarlic is third. Then comes Eye Catcher, then Waterbuck and Happy Ranger, then Forest King. And Carroll Street is next, and at the third last, it's Red Rum over in the lead, chased by Churchtown Boy. The Pilgarlic is third, Eye Catcher fourth, Waterbuck is fifth, Happy Ranger is sixth. Then Forest King seventh, Carroll Street 8th, and we've got to look a long way back for anything else, but Red Rum the leader across the Milling Road, Churchtown Boy closing, the Pilgarlic in 3rd place, Eye Catcher 4th, and over to you, Peter.
And it's Red Rum with two loose horses around him now, just two fences left to jump between he and Grand National History, but close in behind him is Churchtown Boy, the Pilgarlic is about 6 lengths away, then comes the Mare Eye Catcher, and then Waterbuck, and behind them Happy Ranger, then Forest King and Carroll Street. They're virtually the only ones left in the 1977 Grand National, and Churchtown Boy is still making relentless progress. Martin Blackshaw coming there very sweetly on Churchtown Boy, but Red Rum is still holding the lead now as they jump the second last. He's over the second last in the lead. Churchtown Boy didn't jump it too well, and it's Red Rum and Tommy Stack now from Churchtown Boy, the Pilgarlic and Eye Catcher, as they come to the last fence in the National, and Red Rum with a tremendous chance of winning his third National. He jumps it clear of Churchtown Boy. He's getting the most tremendous cheer from the crowd. They're winning him home now. The 12-year-old Red Rum being preceded only by loose horses, being chased by Churchtown Boy. Eye Catcher has moved into third and the Pilgarlic fourth. They're coming to the elbow. There's a furlong now between Red Rum and his third Grand National triumph, and he's coming up to the line to win it like a fresh horse in great style. His hat's off and a tremendous reception. You've never heard one like it at Liverpool. Red Rum wins the National. Coming up towards the line, a tired now but game, Churchtown Boy holds Eye Eyecatcher. Churchtown Boy is second. Eyecatcher is third. Fourth is the Phil Garlic and fifth Forest King. Sixth is Waterbuck and seventh is Happy Ranger. Eighth is Carroll Street and ninth will be Collingwood.
Red Rum remains the only horse ever to win three Grand Nationals, and his remarkable record in the world's greatest steeplechase, three wins and 2 seconds in five attempts, will surely never be surpassed.
Rides in on his first Grand National win.
There's Aldeniti, one of the three class horses in the race, and what a fairy tale this would be if Bob Champion could bring him home.
But for sheer emotional charge, Red Rum's unforgettable 1977 victory was pushed to a photo finish by the 1981 renewal. Four-times champion jockey Josh Gifford had never won the race, but he was now a leading trainer and had a major prospect in the shape of Aldeniti, back in action after a bout of severe leg trouble.
It's Caro Boy of the spotted cap. Aldeniti was spotted there just in behind Spartan Missile.
If Aldeniti's presence in the 1981 field represented triumph over adversity, the presence of his rider, Bob Champion,